Hello friends, now we see the problem number 2, sub question 2, which is also based on arithmetic progression of chapter, sequence and series. The sub question 2 is 1, comma, minus 4 upon 2, comma, 7 upon 4, comma, minus 10 upon 8, comma, 13 upon 16, comma, minus 16 upon 32, comma, going on. So for this question, we have to find sum to infinity. Now let's see the solution. The solution is quite simple. First of all, the given terms can be written as 1 into 1, comma, 4 into minus 1 by 2, comma, 7 into 1 by 4, comma, 10 into minus 1 upon 8, comma, 13 into 1 by 16, comma, and going on. Now we consider the first terms only. Therefore, the numbers one, comma, four, comma, 7, 10, 13, going on, are in AP with first term A equal to 1 and common difference D equal to 4 minus 1, that equal to 3. Now we consider the second numbers only. The numbers 1, comma, minus 1 upon 2, comma, 1 upon 4, minus 1 upon 8, comma, 1 upon 16, and going on, are in GP with first term A equal to 1 and common ratio R equal to minus 1 upon 2 upon 1. So that equal to minus 1 upon 2. So in this way, we get for AP, first term A equal to 1, common difference D equal to 3, and for GP, we get common ratio R is equal to minus 1 upon 2. Now for arithmetico geometric sequence, we have formula for SN that SN is equal to A upon 1 minus R plus D into R in bracket 1 minus R raised n minus 1 whole thing divided by 1 minus R the bracket square minus A plus n minus 1 into D bracket complete into R raised n and whole thing divided by 1 minus R. Now in this formula, we substitute A equal to 1, D equal to 3 and R equal to minus 1 by 2. We get SN is equal to A upon 1 minus and R also minus 1 by 2. So minus minus we get plus 1 by 2. Plus for D we write 3 into R minus 1 by 2 in bracket 1 minus minus 1 by 2 whole bracket raise n minus 1 bracket complete upon 1 minus minus 1 by 2. So it become 1 plus 1 by 2 the whole bracket square, then minus 1 plus n minus 1 into 3 bracket complete upon 1 plus 1 by 2 and into 1 by 2 whole bracket raise n. Therefore, the Sn is equal to 1 upon 1 plus 1 by 2 on cross multiplying, we get 3 upon 2. Now, plus minus minus in the numerator, we have 3 into 1 by 2 bracket 1 minus minus 1 by 2 raise n minus 1, that entire term we write as it is. Now in the denominator, we have 1 plus half, so that gives 3 by 2, and 3 by 2 the whole square. It means we have 9 upon 4. Then minus, in the numerator, we have 1 plus 3n minus 3 bracket complete. Then into minus 1 upon 2. Whole bracket raise n upon 1 plus half, we get 3 by 2. Now on further simplifying, we get Sn is equal to 2 upon 3 minus 3 into 1 by 2 into 4 by 9 in bracket 1 minus minus 1 by 2 raise n minus 1 minus 2 by 3 in bracket 3n 1 minus 3 gives minus 2 bracket complete into minus 1 upon 2 raise n. As n becomes infinitely large, so the term minus 1 upon 2 raise n minus 1 comma minus 1 upon 2 raise n becomes 0. Therefore, the sum to infinity is given by S infinity is equal to 2 upon 3 minus 3 into 1 by 2 into 4 by 9 in bracket 1 minus the minus 1 by 2 raise n minus 1 is replaced by 0, then minus 2 by 3 in bracket 3n minus 2 into minus 1 by 2 whole bracket raise n. So therefore, S infinity is equal to 2 by 3 minus, now here if you go for cancellation, that 2 ones are 2 and 2 twos are 4, 3 ones are 3 and 3 threes are 9. So we left with 2 by 3 in bracket 1 minus 0, then minus 2 by 3, then 3n minus 2 and for minus 1 by 2 raised n, we replace 0 as n tends to infinity. So finally we have s infinity is equal to 2 by 3 minus 2 by 3 minus 0. And therefore s infinity is equal to 0. So in this case, the sum to infinity of arithmetico-geometric progression is s infinity is equal to 0. So this is the required solution for the given problem. Thank you.